Most transition metal compounds are colored in their aqueous solution and in the solid state. When visible light is incident on a substance, electrons within get excited from lower energy d orbitals to the higher energy d orbitals. Now, mind you, we are not talking about excitation of electrons between different energy levels. There's no quantum jumping of excitation and de-excitation taking place here. You have to recall that all of the d orbitals aren't degenerate, right? They're not of the same energies. There is a d2g-eg reorganization of the d orbitals. Now, according to the crystal field theory, you have to understand that excitation can take place between these two levels as well. This excitation corresponds to the energy of light absorbed. The unabsorbed light, falling in the visible spectrum, is what we perceive as the color of the substance. That is, if we see that a solution is purple in color, that means that yellow light has been absorbed by the substance and purple's let out. Now, it must become evident to you that if there are no electrons in the d orbitals, or all the d orbitals are completely filled, paired up with electrons, such reorganizations don't happen, which can lead to promotion of electrons, right? And we will have colorless substances. Which is why scandium 3 plus ions, or salts of scandium 3 plus ions, Ti4 plus ion salts are colorless, and Cu plus and Zn2 plus salts are colorless. Let's bring up a snapshot of different salts, rather different ions. Note the color formed by the various ions. It would be useful to make a correlation between the electronic configuration, or the number of unpaired electrons inside of the ions, and the number of empty d orbitals, and the charge on the transition metal ion, and of course the color that it exhibits in solution.
For more videos and live lectures on the JEE, click on the subscribe button now.